Hi, my name is Dancee Pinkston. For those of you who don't know me, also known as Fearless Momma. And on this channel, I like to make mindset, intentional, and motherhood videos just to encourage you guys. And I'm just on the path to becoming a Fearless Momma. So that's what that is. So a little background story. I was 40 weeks and 2 days pregnant. And I had been searching, of course, how to induce labor at home naturally, or how to naturally induce labor, and I came across some crazy things. And really, like, scientifically, what I found is what I'm going to be sharing with you, and stuff that is really going to work, not just a coincidence or things like that. So basically, I kind of boiled it down to like a science, I guess, and just what made sense in my mind. So technically, you cannot induce labor unless your baby is ready. What you can do is make it the optimal environment and the optimal position for your baby, if that makes sense. So let's get into it. Okay, so going back to baby won't come unless they are ready. This is so real, you guys. Baby won't come unless they're ready. Not like because they're just being stubborn or just want to make you feel like a gigantic house, but because it literally, their brain develops and grows, and there's hormones that are involved that signal to your hormones that they are ready. And also, they have to be ready in the correct birthing position, or a good birthing position technically. There's other exceptions, I guess, to this, because obviously there's breech babies and all different types of going into labor and the baby not being in the correct position, but what I'm going to share with you is going to make a whole lot more sense. Okay, when we are thinking about inducing labor at home fast, we have to think of two things, and it is promoting the birth hormones, and two, making sure the baby's head is engaged into the pelvis. So promoting birth hormones, the birth hormones are oxytocin and melatonin that I am talking about. So oxytocin is your love, peace hormone, your just like your comfort hormone, and really comes from like contentment and just being comfortable, positive, and prepared. And your melatonin hormone rises in darkness, dark, quiet places, dim lights, staying upright helps promote this, and still, slow breathing. So number two, the baby's head being engaged in the pelvis is super important. There are certain stretches and techniques you can do, and really focusing on your posture to help the baby get into the correct birthing position. So there's, you know, a correct way to sit on your exercise ball. If you didn't know that, you may need to not be sitting on your exercise ball or doing circles if your baby's not engaged in the correct birthing position. Certain ways to stand and sit and lay, and just your overall core alignment and balance to your pelvis. We get a lot of, you know, we're crossing our legs and sitting crunched up on our couches, and well, you may not be able to do that when you're big and pregnant, but for the most part, you may be just like chillaxing and just in the butt tucked position. And this was a big issue with my daughter, and really why she wasn't coming, why my labor was being stalled. I noticed I was having stalled labor, early labor signs. So I was pretty much in early labor for about 3 days, and I could tell like nothing was happening. I would have a contraction every 10 minutes, nothing too painful. It just wasn't picking up and wasn't rolling the ball. So I knew I had to get my daughter in a good birthing position, and I'm going to share with you kind of the 10 techniques that I used the day I went into labor. That night I went into labor after doing these three techniques. Before I go into my ideas for you or the how-tos for you, I really want you to understand this. So I'm gonna go into like just a little bit of explanation on how this really works and how hormones work and how getting your baby engaged works. This is something I talk about a lot in my Fearless Pregnancy and Birth course. I love to go within the science of birth and just the hormones and just the fear process that happens. So I'm going to use Landry's little doll to help explain this. So if your baby is in the correct birthing position, which is technically like this, Landry was like this forever and like this and like this, and she was a wild woman. I called her my little acrobat. Anyways, so the baby's head is in a good position and it's pushing against the cervix. It sends nerve impulses from the cervix to mommy's brain. So then the brain stimulates the pituitary gland to secrete more oxytocin. So then oxytocin is carried from the brain via the bloodstream to your uterus. Okay, and then oxytocin stimulates the uterus to contract and push baby further down into the cervix, which then, you know, does the whole cycle again. So it's a snowball effect that gets stronger and stronger, and we want to promote oxytocin as much as possible. But remember, we can't have baby unless baby is ready. Of course, there's exceptions with preterm labors and things like that. But technically, the baby's brain, when it's finished developing, gets a level of these hormones that signals to the mother to release oxytocin. So we're getting releases of oxytocin everywhere, signaling everywhere, and it's just a big, incredible process. Oxytocin stimulates those powerful contractions that help to thin and dilate the cervix and move the baby down and out of the birth canal. But none of this matters unless melatonin, another hormone, is thrown into the mix of things. So like I said, melatonin is released in dark, quiet places or dark, quiet settings, and it boosts that oxytocin and works synergistically with oxytocin. Okay, so there are three big things that I focused on when I was going past my due date. By the way, we don't know for sure our due dates technically, and you know, babies, you know, develop and grow at different times, so it might have been Landry's exact time she was ready, but I really felt like I enhanced the moment and sped it up really quickly. I had my daughter that night and she was in my arms within 3 hours of my first contraction, so I think that's pretty amazing. So I focused on the mood, my mood. I focused on any negative emotions that would hinder labor from happening, and I just got rid of them. Something I really talk about in my Fearless Pregnancy and Birth course on how to release negative emotions and fill them up with positive ones. I really focused on love and peace and comfort and making sure I was surrounded by those things. You know, keeping positive, making sure everyone around me was being positive. I wasn't watching things that were negative. No, like, scary negative movies that would, you know, get my heart rate up or stress me out. Just really relaxing, fun things were happening in the Pinkston home. And I really made sure that I was comfortable and that my home and my mind were prepared. So that's technically where the nesting comes from. You want to feel prepared and ready so that we can uplift those birthing hormones. Okay, the next thing I really focused on was my environment, the setting. The day I went into labor, I made sure it was dark and quiet. This was more at night. During the day, we had our normal peaceful day. But at night, I really started to dim the lights and make sure I was being quiet and it was dark, like it made a spa-like environment would be a good idea. I shut the doors so that you can't hear any loud sounds or, you know, cars driving or your husband watching football on the TV, which literally was happening. I shut the door, went into my room, and made sure it was quiet. It would be a good idea to not look at your screen or phones and just let that moonlight come in. Or you could have on your blue blocker or blue light blocker glasses, whatever they're called, and that should really help. So you want to really focus on keeping warm, making sure you're not cold. You could crank up the heat or bundle up in a lot of blankets like I did. You know, get on your warm socks, your warm clothes. You could even get a hot blanket fresh out of the dryer. Another major thing that I really did with the setting is I made sure I was being relaxed and having relaxed, slow, diaphragmatic breathing. It opens the pelvic floor actually and lowers the fight or flight stress response. So it helps just really relax the body. And also it increases the parasympathetic nervous system, which is your restful, calming body system that we need to promote that oxytocin. I learned how to do diaphragmatic breathing from Olivia. Her name is Olivia Cagle. She has a Fit Pregnancy Boot Camp and also a free master class, which I will link down in the description box below. It is super, super helpful, and she teaches a lot in that free master course. So I'd highly recommend going and checking that out on how to breathe through your ribs and not your chest and not your stomach. So the third thing, and I wouldn't say the most important, but because it all goes hand in hand and it all is a snowball effect, but this is really what I think just tipped the iceberg that day. So baby head engagement, that's so important. I could tell Landry was not engaged at all by the number of times she was flipping around, turning around in my stomach, and I really, really just felt like she has to get engaged for this to keep going. So I had my family pray that day, and I was doing specific techniques and exercises and really made sure that last 3 weeks of pregnancy that I was keeping my posture, making sure I was balanced and in a core alignment. So those are two things that you need to know when you think of baby head engagement or getting the baby engaged, is keeping core alignment, making sure your hips are not tucked and you're just in core alignment. You know, no crossing legs, no slouching, no twisting, no, none of that weird stuff that we so do here in America. Just with how much we sit, you know, we're not in that Eastern squat, you know, working on something in a squatting position. We are mainly like standing up on our feet, probably in a poor posture, core alignment, or slouching on our couch or sitting in the chairs wrong. Okay, so one thing that you really want to do when you think about getting your baby's head engaged is if your baby is in the correct birthing position, you really want to focus on gravity. You want to work with gravity. So if you're really trying to induce labor this day at home, I would really, really suggest standing upright for most of the day. Stay upright as much as possible, but you really want to make sure that you are in the proper core alignment. And Olivia goes over that a lot in her Fit Pregnancy Boot Camp. And she may go over it in her master class, but I'm not sure. So the best way that I remembered how to do this was to stand and pretend like my hips were a bucket. And you want to make sure your bucket is just a little bit tilted forward. You don't want to be where your butt is tucked backwards, or your butt tucking, and you don't want to be, you know, hanging over too much, but you want to make a pretty good sling for your baby and the baby's back. You want to make a little sling for your baby's back to lay in your belly. That helps a lot. with getting your baby in the correct birthing position and really prevents your baby getting stuck on your pelvic bone, where it can just like, you know, not get into the birth canal, but really kind of its head be overlapping your pelvic bone and not slip into the birth canal. So if you have to sit down, I suggest sitting correctly on an exercise ball. One note that I really, really learned from spinningbabies.com was to make sure your hips are always higher than your knees. Your knees need to be lower than your hips, and that just again helps make sure your body's in the correct alignment. Let me know if you're learning from this, because this was just all so mind-blowing for me. So in the comments below, let me know if you are learning from this and what your favorite tip was. Another thing that I learned from spinning babies was to sit on a pillow to help tilt those hips a little forward into pretending like your hips are a bucket. Helps, you know, tilt them a little forward. You don't want to be butt tucking, is what Olivia calls it all the time. Another tip for you is that you could sit in the chairs backwards, like with your arms on the back of the chair with your legs kind of straddling it. You kind of want to, at the end of your pregnancy at least, take on kind of manly posture, and forget about crossing your legs or, you know, things like that. So you want to kind of be leaning forward, sitting on your sits bones, and not chillaxing like this with your belly up, because that, you know, goes against gravity. And you want to, you know, kind of have your hips always higher than your knees, your knees lower than your hips. And, you know, a lot of this is talked about in Olivia's masterclass video. She talks about like where your ribs should be and how your butt should be and all of that good stuff. So I really highly recommend checking that out. The last thing I did, which was what I did the day I went into labor, are these spinning babies stretches and techniques. They focus on flipping your baby into the correct position, whether they are breech, transverse, sunny side up like Landry was, or just however they are. They have loads of information on how to go into labor naturally by getting your baby's head engaged and getting your baby in the correct birthing position. Anyways, I did what's called the Fantastic Four techniques at the time, is what they really focused on calling it. But I believe it's now called the Three Sisters, and then they kind of have this other technique for when you're actually in labor. But again, there are step-by-step instructions on how to do these techniques and exercises on their website. And I have the link in the description box below, because there's a lot of information and you can kind of get lost if you just go to their website. So I'll put the specific link down below. So I learned all of that after watching the Spinning Babies parent class. It was so helpful, and I'm so glad I purchased that. The techniques can be a little awkward, and especially if you're not used to, you know, getting in those types of positions, you could feel a bit awkward. But I was comfortable with it because I had been working out with Olivia's Fit Pregnancy Bootcamp my whole pregnancy. I was doing other exercises as well that I don't recommend, but I do recommend the safe diastasis safe workouts, pregnancy safe workouts from Olivia. They're awesome. She films them in her kitchen and she's just so raw and real, and you'll love her. Anyway, so you do need a help of a partner or somebody who can help you do side lying release. That one you need someone's help, like especially on that one. Yeah, so that day I did a set in the morning, a set at lunchtime, and a set at night. And I'm not kidding you, I got into bed, I had my essential oils going and the diffuser, and I know that really, really helps with emotions and targeting releasing emotions and all that good stuff. I believe I had peace and calming or gentle baby in the diffuser, and so it just, you know, set the setting, I guess I would say, to just that spa-like environment. And I actually felt her spin in my stomach, get in the correct position. I texted my family who had been praying that she flipped and I'm gonna have her in the morning. And I got in bed, said a little prayer, did my devotion. I said that I'm ready, you know, getting my mind prepared, getting mentally prepared, and my water broke. And it was the craziest thing. Like, as I was saying amen, my water broke, and I was just laying in bed, and it was crazy. I had my daughter in 3 hours in my arms. So the last thing I suggest doing is doing the exercise ball correctly, especially if your baby's not in the correct position. I highly recommend asking your OB or midwife if you think they're in the correct position. Normally you can feel their little hands to help you know where they are in the body. I can definitely tell where Landry was because of how much she kicked. But if she were in the correct position, I would be doing circles and you know, really helping her just move and loosen up my pelvis to get in that perfect birthing position and deeper engaged in the birth canal, or pressing onto the cervix, because you know that produces more oxytocin, which does the contractions and all that good stuff. That would be super, super helpful to do if your baby is head down and in the correct position. If not, just sit on the exercise ball wherever you are. I would put it at the dinner table and I would sit on it with my hips tilted forward, my knees down. And I really felt like it made a difference in promoting gravity and Landry's head being pressed on the cervix. Definitely do safe prenatal workouts. There are some out there that are not safe, and there are some that can cause the separation of the abdomen, diastasis, and I highly recommend Olivia Cagle's Fit Pregnancy Boot Camp. It was incredible. Highly recommend looking at spinning babies and getting their parent class and even their yoga sequence. I loved that, especially in the last week. I loved doing that because you're so big, your hips are starting to ache and spread, and that was just so, so helpful. One of those exercises or stretches saved me. Like,